points? Because a dodecahedron is what, like 20? Something like that? Come on. Come on. Work with me. Work with me. I got an unlabeled flu swab. Now I wait for the doctors to call angrily because they haven't gotten results. Dude, it's their fault for sending unlabeled. Like, who does that? The nurses do. And besides, how did they send you an unlabeled one? That doesn't make sense. And what can you do with it since it's unlabeled? Crap, don't call nice, don't call nice. Oh, ski shot. Okay. Green. Your concern and care for ball led you to a delicious victory. You are awarded one gold. This flag has nothing else to offer. Okay, fair enough. That was very random. Can we do it again? Throw it away? Oh, so you just throw away if it's unlabeled? Okay. Because, I mean, that also makes sense that you would throw it away because, like, say if a doctor calls and they're like, you know, I've seen, like, five people in the ER at, like, what, 12 o'clock tonight who had the flu, so we need you to process this. I'm losing it. Come on. Got it. It's so tiny. It's purple. Even when you felt trapped, you took notes and achieved the end of the ball. You are awarded 2 gold. So, do you get more gold the better you do or the worse that you do? It looks like I got more gold because the worse I did. Give me a second. I'm gonna read that message, but I kind of want to get the snowball in before it melts. Or the snow decahedron. No. Come on, dude. Work with me. Don't hit, buddy. Yes. Sideways kick. Go. Nope. God, no. Okay, how's it on the ice? Okay, there we go. Keep down. Side. No, go down. Okay, whatever. We're not doing that again. Because I can't confirm it's the patient stage claim it is. Yeah, that would make sense, that since you can't claim it. You don't wanna call someone positive and then they're not positive for it. Human, I hope you're ready for this paper on the ground. Sans, where's the puzzle? It's right there on the ground. Trust me, there's no way they can get past this one. I will just Sans didn't even look at it. Oops. I knew I should have used today's crossword instead. What? I can't believe you said that. In my opinion, Junior Jumbo is easily the hardest. In my opinion, Sudoku can be the hardest. What? Dude, that's easy peasy words, Grandpa. That's for baby bones. Believable. Human, solve this dispute. Which is harder, Jumbo or crossword? You gotta choose crossword, because if it's just jumble, you can kind of figure it out by, you know, trial and error, aggressive trial and error. Crossword puzzles, you gotta have a big enough diction to be able to take those hints correctly. But that's just me personally. So I would say crossword. So we're going with crossword, unless chat disagrees with me. Handle that. Let me get some water real quick. Yes. Crosswords are more difficult. Okay. Yeah, I agree with that one. And I want to take it Sam's. You two are weird. You mean us? 4 to 5. 5 to 6 are weird. Crosswords are so easy. It's the same solution. What? You just fill all the boxes with... Oh my god.
What?
You just fill all the boxes with the letter Z? I mean... Technically that's right. Because that forms a word in the end. Because every time I look at a crossword, all I can do is snore. Sleep joke. Yeah. But real talk, what was on this piece of paper? Master Kid's word search. I see. Hey kids, can you help me solve this puzzle? Guys, what is the third word on the third line next to mermaid? Like, that seems a little out of place. Like, a lot of out of place for a crop for this. What is that even? What does that spell? Like, let me actually Google that. How do you even say that word? I mean, it almost looks German to me. Okay, it looks like this only pulls up spoilers for the rest of the game, so we're glad we're gonna skip that. We're not gonna click on anything, but what? That does not make sense right now. I guess that'll make sense in the future. Prize finds difficulty in interesting places. Yesterday he got stumped trying to solve the horoscope. You don't solve it, dude. You just like. Like, what? Hey, this is so weird. Anyway, we'll come back to that. Knowing the mice might one day find a way to heat up spaghetti. Fills you with determination. So let me get this right. We left out spaghetti for the mouse to warm up in a microwave. And evolution takes that path. I am doomed. I personally am doomed. That path takes any way. And people in New York are definitely doomed at that point. It's a plate of frozen spaghetti. It's so cold it's stuck to the table. Well, damn. What about the microwave? Is it at least plugged into something? Yeah. What are they trying to do with this mouse, man? What are they doing? As a note from the prize. Human, please enjoy this spaghetti. Little do you know, this spaghetti is a trap. Nom nom nom, salt and vinegar chips. Dude, why would you want salt and vinegar chips? We have frozen plate spaghetti in the woods with a microwave that is not plugged in that has a setting for spaghetti. Mind you, the spaghetti is frozen to the table. Designed to entice you. You'll be so busy eating it that you won't realize that you aren't progressing. Thoroughly shaped again by the great prize. He actually types out his laughter. Okay. But it's frozen. And this clearly tells me the spaghetti is here for a mouse. And there's clearly a mouse up here, because you can hear the sound. See, listen. So, I mean, there's clearly a mouse in there, but I guess. You stay on. Warning, dog marriage. What? What? What does that even mean? We'll be right back. This should be interesting. We got an ice cap, a snow drake, in front you sign, Jerry. What's wrong with Jerry? Let's check Jerry out. Everyone knows Jerry makes attacks 2 seconds longer. Fireball. But we don't have any magic actually. We know how to handle the snow drake. We need to laugh at that. Yeah, I missed that one. Snowdrake is pleased with his cool joke. Yes, spare mercy to him. Guys, it's cold. That's basic. Jerry eats powdery food and licks his hand loudly. What? Oh, how do we handle Jerry? Okay. We ignore the ice cap, so let's see what happens. Jerry lets out a yawn. Jerry sneezes without covering his nose. Dude, good job. They teach me some brandy. Okay, Jerry. Spare him. How does Jerry work? Like, ditching him just seems wrong. Alright, let's check with him. Yeah, this is awkward. There's a switch in the snow. That RPG logic. The switch is stuck now. Okay, let's continue forward. Because apparently there's a dog marriage that we're gonna witness. Because there is. That literally just looks like he's whited out the entire screen. Is that a QR code? Is that. Why is there a phone here? Why can't I click on it? Rick? Is that Pius's face? Kinda looks like it. Oh, that's where the switch is located. Okay. I understand now. I see what he's trying to do. Excuse me, the entrance, and then you go up, you click on the switch, and then you come down, you can actually leave. Okay. That looks like a monster. Like the way those two things are drawn, these little eyes, little mouth, big mouth. Who are these hooligans? Wait, this must be his and her. If you're a smell, identify your smell if. There's that weird smell. It makes me want to eliminate you. Aww. They're kissing. So this is the his and her that they were talking about. And their name is Dogamai and Dog Arista? Arista? We clearly know that they can't see us. So I guess petting them would be the best course of action. Mm-hmm. Step, don't touch her. What? The dogs are practicing for their next couples contest? Okay. Alright, let's see if we can pet the male dog then. Dogs are too suspicious. Paws off, you smelly human. That's not your husband. So they clearly don't. Oh crap, they actually can't hit. Okay, so the blue ones are good. But we're not really supposed to move, are we? The dogs keep shifting their axes to protect each other. Okay, we know that petting doesn't do anything. What is re-sniffing? How's that work? Alright, let's re-sniff them. The dogs sniff you again. But you smell just as weird as before. Sniff. What's that smell? It smells mystery. The dogs are reevaluating our smell. Okay. What happens if we sniff? Oh, I think I need to roll around in the dirt and then let them sniff. Why is the blue hurting now? Why is the blue hurting? Okay, roll around. You roll around in dirt and snow. You smell like a weird... Okay. Do humans have tails? Like, is it every other blue that hurts now? Dogs want their really smell. Re-sniff me, homies! After rolling in there, you smell alright. Wait, it smells like a... Are you actually a little puppy? Wait, what?! That was not what I thought was gonna happen. The dogs are thinking that you may be a lost puppy. Oh, okay, they won't be like even that. So weird. The dogs think you must be a lost puppy. Okay, I need to pet a female dog now. A dog that pets dogs in the face. I don't know how to really dodge that. So there's my second game over. Rip! Stay determined. Stay frosty, my friend. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure, like, how to dodge that one. Alright, but anyway, at least we know kind of what's happening here. Like, we know we need to roll around in the dirt first, and then we need to, let them re-sniff me. Dude, Jerry is literally the wingman to all of them. He kind of just tags along. No one cares if it's cold. We prefer the cold weather. We don't like being outside where it's hot and swampy all the time. Jerry, what are you thinking about? Except for extending how long it takes for us to do this. Jerry, that's going on. Let's go ahead. This is annoying. And then we ditch. Cool, that was easy. Alright, let's continue forward. Okay, so we got that. We need to figure out this dog thing. That's so weird. He's like Mr. Poopy Butthole from Rick and Morty. Yeah, he kind of is like Mr. Poopy Butthole, only he's not as cool. At least Mr. Poopy Butthole actually, like, has a reason to be around. Okay. I need to roll around. We learned that in the first try. I just find that so weird. Too much love in these attacks, that's all I can say. No, dirt, you smell hard. Smells like, are you a little puppy? This is so weird. Like, you think I'm a lost puppy. Like, I just don't understand. I guess they were saying, as I take damage twice, that's my bad. That was not the only one. Does think you may be a lost puppy? Okay. Me. Wait, I love sniffing again. There you know your smell fine. Okay. So there has to be something else after that. And I guess petting is the next course of action. As they float love at me so hard. Okay, I don't want this. Like, I guess I have to be underneath and like keep moving as they go. Like, if I die, I'll try to get dogs and mines have been expanded. Oh, there won't be another next time. We are straight up mercying sparing them. Deuces, homie. We are not doing that again. Dogs can pet other dogs. A new world has opened up for us. Thanks, weird puppy. I mean, dogs do pet each other. Like, when they're playing, they'll sometimes jump on top of each other and it kind of, like, they're petting each other. I mean, that's what it looks like to me, at least. Like, arr, pet, 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 pet. And then they, like, kind of push each other's, because I, like, bang my keyboard. They push each other's heads down, so that, oh, no, that was interesting. Moving along, then. Turn X into O, then press the switch. Okay. This does not look like a horror puzzle. Yeah, that wasn't that hard, Pius. What? How did you avoid my trap? Bro, it was kind of simple. And more importantly, is there any... Is there any what? Oh, he's talking about the spaghetti? Oh, bro, I left that. You resisted the flavor of my home-cooked pasta. It was frozen on a plate with a microwave that doesn't work. Just so you could share it with me? Yeah, man, I thought of you before I got here. Fret not, human. I'm Master Chef for Pius. Make you all the pasta you could ever want. Knee high. I'm making friends? I guess? My brother started a sock collection recently. Why? Okay. How sad. I think I have to sneeze. Hold on, guys. Nope, I don't have to sneeze. Okay, anyway, how sad. Sometimes I wonder what he would do without such a cool guy taking care of him. I don't know either. Okay, what about the switch? Okay, fine. Human. How do I say this? You are taking a long time to arrive, so I decided to improve this puzzle by arranging the snow to look more like my face. Okay. Fortunately, the snow froze to the ground. Now the solution is different. I mean, yeah, that's kind of what it does. Do you have a stick in game? I don't have a stick in game. I have a toy knife, but it's in my storage. Why would I need a stick? Oh, to play with the dogs? No, I mean, yeah. But I don't have a stick, though. Because you remember I found that one branch, but I couldn't lift it. Because it was a mighty branch. But, yeah, so I have run across a quote-unquote stick. But it was too big for me to carry or bring along to give to the dogs. Because, I don't know. And besides, these dogs apparently love smoking bones. So, I don't know what to tell you. My lazy brother is nowhere around. I suppose what I'm saying is, worry not, human. That cape flowing so hard. Just wriggle that cape in, guys. Alright, the Great Papyrus will solve this conundrum. You do that for us. We can both can proceed. You could have made them play fetch and then fetch it and spare two. Yeah, that it would have worked, but dude, that would have been hilarious. It's kind of like how we were looking for another dog so that we could what is it? So that we could see, like, if we keep petting it, the neck would keep expanding. Like, we never ran into another one. So, you know, there's some stuff we're missing because we haven't seen another one. Meanwhile, feel free to try the puzzle yourself. Try not to give away the answer. Try not to give away the answer. We're the only two people here. Turn every X into O's and then press switch. Alright, give me a second. Let me actually think about this puzzle. Because there has to be a way that you can do it all one way. But I know that there's exits, so we can do it a little bit easier. But give me a second. Let me actually try to figure this out. Because I got half of it done right now, but getting the other half is what's kind of annoying. Let's see. Like, should we cut it short and then do it? Yeah, we'll just cut it short and then do it. I messed up. Crap. Alright, okay. Can you set it? Alright, here we go. Then start there. That way we can possibly come up here. Messed it up again. Yeah, I messed that one up. That was my bad. It was so close though. I figured it halfway out, so we're almost there. Okay, maybe. No, I was about to say, if we could leave that one without turning into a circle, then we could make it work. But he was like, no. Let's restart. This might take a minute. I'm actually a little stumped on this one. Because I thought I had it at first. I know we have to at least go down on the second eye, at least the right eye, all the way. But no, that won't work either. Crap. I messed up. Like, how do you actually keep it going? Especially since, like, if you backtrack. So one thing we don't want to backtrack. So it almost seems like this might work. Nailed it. Nailed it. We got that. But anyway, guys, let me take a little bathroom break on this one, and I'll be right back. Okay, I am back. Let's solve this puzzle. Yeah, I solved it. Bro, we solved it. It took us a few tries, but we got it. And you did it all without my help. Of course. Incredible. I'm impressed. You must care about puzzles like I do. Not really gonna drive. Well, I'm sure you'll love the next puzzle, then. It might even be too easy for you. And then there's Saiyans. Like, why is he here? Good job on solving it so quickly. When did he get here is my question. Because he was not here a few seconds ago, as I make sure the mic is still on. Even though I can, like, easily just look at the OBS and see. But anyway, moving on. Good job. job on solving it so quickly. You didn't even need my help, which is great because I love doing absolutely nothing. Really?
Really?
Okay, moving on. Is there a switch in here? I don't know how I feel about this puzzle. Hey, it's the human. You're gonna love this puzzle. Question. It was made by the great Dr. Alphonse. I can hear you? Okay, cool. I was just making sure because I thought the mic might still be muted. Because sometimes in the headset I can hear it. I can hear myself. Like, it kind of verifies that it's still on. But I also was checking OBS and I see the microphone audio going like doo 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 doo. You see these towels? Once I throw this switch, they will begin to change colors. Okay. Each color has a different function. Red towels are impassable. Okay. You cannot walk on them. Dance, dance, revolution. I know, dude. That's exactly what I expect this to turn out to be. Yellow towels are electric. That makes sense too. They will electrocute you. No duh. Green towels are alarms. Wait, what? If you step on them, you will have to fight a monster. Okay, we'll step on green ones. Orange towels are orange scented.
What?
Like, is there a reason behind that one? It will make you smell delicious. I mean, oranges are delicious. Blue towels are water towels. Swim through if you like, but if you smell like oranges, the piranhas will bite you. That doesn't make any sense. Wait, piranhas, they're not, I mean, do they eat fruit? Can we verify if piranhas eat fruit? Because I think they're purely meat eaters. Also, if a blue towel is next to a yellow towel, water will also wet. That makes sense. Paper towels are slippery. When wet, you will slide to the next towel. However, the slippery soap smells like lemons, which piranhas do not like. Purple and blue are okay. Finally, pink towels, they don't do anything. Step on them all you like. How was that? Understand? Dude, that is a lot going on there. I actually might have needed to write that stuff down. Understand the explanation? No. Okay, I guess I'll repeat myself. Okay, let me actually write this stuff down, because dear God. What does that say? Okay. What does it say? Know what my handwriting says. Okay, red equals no-go. Yellow equals electric. Blue equal monsters. I'm actually having to write this down because that stuff gets kind of weird. Green or water, which doesn't make any sense. That's water should be. Blue should have been water, but whatever. I don't know. Orange or orange, which means that I can't go into the water because piranhas live in there. Orange equal orange. If you step on an orange, don't step on a green. Okay, so. Wait, hold up. I don't remember him saying anything about brown. Do y'all remember him saying anything about brown towels when he first gave this explanation? I didn't know that there was a brown towel to begin with. Yeah, purple towels smell like lemon. Why don't the yellow ones smell like
what?
A typical roundup to this on insects, fish, crustaceans, worms, carrion seeds, and other plant material. So no oranges.
So
okay. Are y'all following along with this puzzle then? Oh wait, did I mix up green and blue? Oh crap, we are so doomed. We are so doomed with this puzzle. Yay. No, no, he said the blue ones were monsters. Now, are the... Oh my god. Okay, pink tiles, they don't do anything. I remember that. Pink tiles do nothing. Wait, those ones don't do anything. Yeah, that's correct. Okay, do you understand better now? Dude, he just made that so much worse. Like, oh my god. He made that so much worse. Yeah, we don't understand. Okay, you know what? How about you just do this puzzle on your own? I'll leave the instructions. Just read them. Then when you understand it, you can throw the switch and do it at your own pace. Like, I don't think that's how puzzles work. You don't give your foe the answers to the puzzle and then tell them to flip the switch to turn on the puzzle. Then you can just skip the puzzle. And then Sans is just kind of chilling there. Okay. It's illegible chicken scratch. Is he calling out my handwriting? Like, I swear he's calling out my handwriting. Like, I wasn't even gonna be able to read that anyway. The machine isn't working.
Wait, what?
So, there wasn't really a puzzle and the machine didn't work. Okay, whatever. Moving on. Actually, that spaghetti from earlier, it wasn't too bad for my brother. It wasn't too bad for my brother. Since he started cooking lessons, he's been improving a lot. That's cool. Bet if he keeps it up, next year he'll even make something edible. Yay. Just dying. And then he smiles about it. Hey, there's another doge. How's this one? Oh, there's a save point. F everything else, we save first. Knowing that dog will never give up trying to make the perfect snow dog. It fills you with determination. Okay. I take it, is this dog they're referring to? This dog is staring blankly into the snow, waiting for it to turn into art. That's not how that works, bro. You gotta put in some action. I'm gonna float inside the box of... What is that? Prom raisins? Promi raisins? Oh, okay. Aware of dog. Please pet dog. Okay. Please pet dog. Okay. Moving on. There is a... This cannot be a dog, can it? No way this can be a dog. That dog considers itself an artist, but doesn't even know what to create. Well... Just create nothing. That's what some of the artists nowadays have been doing. Like the one artist who literally gave the idea of what his painting would look like to someone and they paid for it. Didn't even paint it, just gave her the idea. If only you could do that. Like, if only people like us could pull off things like that, we'd be so golden. It probably doesn't help that its brain is the size of a piece of kibble. Yeah, about that. This statue of Papyrus. Oh, it's actually snow. Okay. Why sand's on the ground? That's, like, how? Like, what does that mean? Like the like the pride of Papyrus, and then San just being kind of a low-key cool guy. Okay. All X's must equal circles, so let's do this. That is not what I meant to do. I meant to actually go on the top one. Oh, so you can fall off. So that's that can be very inconvenient. So let's try to figure this out. Let's look at it and do it. Okay. I think I see what you do. You start on the lower one, scoot across, go up, go over. Now, this one. In the end, we need to be in the middle. There we go. Nailed it! That was a lot easier than the... Why are we still sliding? What? Is that like a snowball? Or is it because we're in the trees that... Like, what is with this snow decoration that keep falling on us? Like, is someone in here doing this? I know, right? Yeah, that was a good first try. Unlike the Papyrus one. But do y'all see this? Like, each time you go in, you get a new design of snow. Like, what is happening? Yeah, you get like a snowbird, snow hat, snow house. Like, who's doing that? Like, I suspect like something to trigger as we're doing this. That was just a lump of snow. Just a lump. All right, that's the last moment. Do it. I just find that weird that someone's actually giving us snow hats. I'm gonna go that way first. Work it down. Yeah, there's sand, so we'll go the other way first. Excuse me. There's a snow poof. And this is a snow poof. Yeah, so they're all snow poofs. This, however, is a snow poof. Surprisingly, it's a snow poof. What? Snow poof. Is it really a snow? Wait, why are we questioning this? That's some free money! That is a dog. That is not a dog. That is a guard. It's the greater dog. I feel like we should play. Oh, it's not exciting enough to play with yet. Oh, okay. It's still playing for our command. Beckon. What? It's bound towards you, flicking slobber into your face? Okay, bro. Okay, so they have to be blue so they take damage. Dog is seeking affection. Curl up in your lap and his pit pipe. It's so comfortable it falls asleep. Wait, what? Then it wakes up and is so excited. Just like a dog. Crap. So you have to actually have to not be blue when it turns blue. That's my bad. Grass pitting his ground with his front paw. Pet him. Chris, is it? Oh my god, dude, this dog's hyped up. Like, I know what to do, but I'm messing it up. The greater dog picks up all the snow in the area and brings it to you. All the snow. Not one, not the snowball, but all the snow. That dog is very tired. It rests his head on you. Oh, wait, dude, it changed white as soon as it happened. It wants some TLC. Aww. Pet him. As you pet the dog, it senses its entire weight on you. Your movement slows. Yeah, but you still haven't pet enough. Crap. That's another rip that I messed up on. That was my bad. Oh man, that was my bad. At least we know what's up there. And we know how this puzzle works, so we can easily do it. But I'm curious, like, what was the, like, what happens if you go and talk to Saiyans? Like, what happens then? Because, I mean, that's like a little mini boss battle, eh? So let's talk to Saiyans and see what's up with Saiyans first. What's up? There's something in that cave. That's what's up. And we ain't going over there right now. We will go gladly back to this dog. Alright. What a tiny dog house. Yeah, it is tiny compared to what's up here. Oh, wow. I'm actually trying to find the 30 gold that you can get from this notebook right now. There it goes. Looks like you have to like actually click on each one. Alright, let's try this boss battle again. Like, how did he fit that little body into that big body? Into that little pound of snow poof. Alright, let's do this again, guys. Alright, picking him over. Oh my god, why did I do that? Like, why did I do that? You're supposed to just, when it turns blue, just stop and let it cross over you. What? That's like. Good dog is seeking affection. Okay, we gotta hit him now. This is so weird. So excited. I've never seen that one before. This is how Cece will act when it's time to go to bed. She'll lay on the bed and just be like, you're gonna pet me, right? And then when you start petting her, she'll be like, just start kneading. And then you put your face on her. But if you pet her too much, then she's like, stop. Stop with the petting. Alright, what is the next course of action? This gray dog is patting the ground with his front paw. Alright, we'll pet it again. Like, that blows my mind, the fact that all the stuff. Like, okay, dude. Here, though, I want some TLC. Just a little bit. Oh my god. Pet capacity is at 40%. What happens when it gets 100%? Like, you think it's insane.
Oh, snap.
Oh, I'm sorry, with his legs hanging in the air?
That's how you're supposed to do it.
Oh, let's continue.
We can start now.
Okay. What?! Y'all saw that, right? Like, how does that little... Like, how does he control it? With those little legs. For some odd reason, I feel like we need to go back to Sans. Like, I just feel like we're missing something if we don't. Yeah. That's a good question. Like, is it decorated because it wants to be decorated, or is it decorated because it, someone did that to him? Oh, so it doesn't want to be decorated. Oh, that sucks. Not really. That sucks, dude. Yeah, that's undecorated. You remove the striped cane that says, I use this tiny cane to walk home. What is it, a rat that's like pimp limping? Like, pimp limp. Gotta find my other rat chicks. That's a little better. Slightly less irritating. Undecorated. Move. Bob. Wire made of pipe cleaner? Bro. What was I supposed to do with that? Give me the box of non-dog related. What? I thought dogs couldn't eat raisins. Dogs can't eat raisins, can they? Has been lifted. You're welcome. Oh, cool. We can actually spare him now. That was an interesting fight. What is that? What's that? Oh, I can't click on that. What is this place? Can we just see it? It's a door. Yeah, it's a door. Are we supposed to be able to open this door right now? Because it's like, or is there like a certain combination for this thing? We will probably come back to that because that is very random. Or I'll look into it. Hey, not right now, but I'll look into it later. See, like, what's up with that door? There has to be a way to get in there. Okay, reading back the check. I don't remember Brown. Yeah, I already read that. Try snowbird. Play. Then she attacks. Exactly. Then Cece attacks when she's like, you've been petted too much. You've overstimulated me. Leave me be. Are they gonna cut the bridge? Human, this is my final and most dangerous challenge. Cut the bridge that is quite dangerous. White fire. Behold, the gauntlet of deadly terror. When I say the word, I will fully activate. I will fully activate. Do you see the dog? Why is the dog a deadly weapon at this point? Wait, hold on. What am I saying? What am I saying? That makes perfect sense. They're bones. Dogs are quite dangerous to anything made out of bones. Cannons will fire, spikes will swing, blades will slice. Each part will swing violently up and down. Only the tiniest chance of victory will remain. Are you ready? Because I am about to do it. Oh, I thought you said something else. Well, what's the hold? Yeah, me too. I was kind of gonna say anything. I thought we were gonna attack. What's the hold up? Hold up. What's the hold up? Hold up. Ew. I'm about to activate it now. That doesn't look very activated yet. Well, this challenge, it seems maybe too easy to defeat the human with. Dun dun dun. Yeah, we can't use this one. I'm a skeleton with standards. What does that mean? Puzzles are very fair. Except for that dog. Like, that dog does not seem like it's having a fair amount of effort here. My traps are expert cooked. I mean, cocked. Because I did not cook that spaghetti correctly. But whatever. This method is too direct. No class at all. Away it goes. What are you looking at? I'm just as confused as hands. This was another decisive victory for prize. How is this a victory? That was clearly an L. Yeah. Yeah, let's talk to Sans about that one, because that wasn't... That didn't make any sense. I don't know what my brother's going to do now. If I were you, I would make sure I understand blue attacks. Blue attacks meaning that they don't harm you. Welcome to Snowden. Okay. Save point! Didn't mean to click on that. Hello, Chopper. How can I help you? I don't need anything that increases my attack. I need defense. That. The manly bandana. Plus 4 to defense. It has abs on it. It's a bandana with abs on it. Someone should make that up in real life and see if people buy it. It has 11 HP twice. Eat it twice. I mean, that makes sense. It is a bicycle. That's actually quite clever. But anyway, a cinnamon bun. Yes, sir. And we'll also buy the manly bandana. We don't need the tough gloves. We just need the bandana. Let's talk to her. Let's see what's up with her. Say hello. Hiya. Welcome to Snowden. I can't remember the last time I saw a fresh face around here. Where did you come from? The capital? Nah, homie. I came from up there. I don't look like a tourist because I fell down a hole. Are you here by yourself? Just a little bit. What do you do here? You want to know what to do here in Snowden? Ruby has food and the library has information. If you're tired, you can take a nap in the inn. Fair enough. It's right next door. My sister runs it. So it's another bunny. And if you're bored, you can sit outside and watch these wacky skeletons do their thing. Okay. Yes, the cinnamon bun is real. There are two of them, brothers, I think. They just showed up one day ago and asserted themselves. That's weird. That they've been making it seem like they've been here like forever, though. The town has gotten a lot interesting since then. I went down, dude. Fucking having Papyrus around with you all the time. Think about your history class. A long time ago, monsters lived in the ruins back there in the forest.
Okay.
Long story short, we all decided to leave the ruins and head for the end of the cavern.
Fair enough.
stuff. Along the way, some fuzzy folks decided they liked the code and set up Campus Snowden. Oh, and don't think about trying to explore the ruins. The door has been locked for ages, so unless you're a ghost or can borrow under the door, forget about it. Like, we came from the ruins, didn't we? And that's why when we tried to go back in, the door was locked. We couldn't actually go back in. So that kind of makes some sense. Life is the same as usual. A little claustrophobic. But we all know deep down that freedom is coming, don't we? As long as we got that hope, we can grit our teeth and face the same struggles day after day. That's life, ain't it? Like, what kind of freedom are they trying to do? Bye-bye now. Come again sometime. Okay, let's equip that item. Where is it? Got some nice cream. Mini bandana. Mini bandana. Oh, going to Cinnabon today? More than likely. I'll probably go to Cinnabon and pick up some Cinnabons and eat them. Eat them. Nom 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 nom. But it depends on the line. It will actually really depend on the line, because that place sometimes be on that. Be on some BS. I don't want to deal with that. It's kind of like going to Popeyes. They always crowded at lunchtime. Makes no sense. But yeah, fun fact. I actually do have a stick. Like, my weapon is a stick. So, I couldn't throw it, but I had a stick though. Okay, let's continue onward. The sight of such a friendly town fills you with determination. Kinda does. Alright, let's deposit all this stuff. Let's deposit all the stuff we don't need. We don't need the faded ribbon. We'll keep the Cinnabon and the nice cream. We'll keep the bandage. How does Popeyes never have chicken ready? Around lunchtime? That is a good question. Like, you had one job, have chicken ready at all times. But at lunchtime, chicken just be nowhere in sight. It makes no sense. Mama says that sleeping can recover your maximum health above your maximum HP. Really? What's maximum HP? Can we just walk up here? Nope, we cannot just walk up here. Alright, let's talk to her. Welcome to the Snowden Premier Hotel. The only one. Yeah, I'm not gonna spend 80G on that one. I only got 190G. Can't waste all my money? What just happened? Oh, okay, it's a teleportation device. Okay. There's actually a lot of people in here. Don't want to walk to the other side of the town? Try the under snow tunnel. They're officially laid out. Okay. But that still doesn't answer the question, like, how do we open that door? That lady over there? Something about her disturbs me. This lady? Is it my little cinnamon just the cutest? What is with cinnamon in this game? Like, I mean, I love cinnamon, but what's up with cinnamon in their world? Buns are so adorable. Like, what in the world is wrong? Buns. Got this little polar bear guy here. Alpha teens tormented a local monster by decorating his trees like horns. I ran into that monster. So we started giving that monster presents to make it feel better. Okay. Now it's a tradition to put presents underneath a decorated tree. Oh, so they actually developed Christmas, basically. So that's pretty cool. It's a carefully decorated tree. Some of the presents are addressed from Santa to various locals. Okay. You see this guy, well, this girl right here? Because I take it that's a bow on top of her head. She looks straight up like Flapjack from, what is it? The Misadventures of Flapjack? She looks like Flapjack, and she also looks like Scraggy the Pokemon. Like, she straight up looks like Scraggy. Scraggy and Flapjack came together, and they formed this character. Yo, you're a kid too, right? I can tell because you're wearing a striped shirt. We've discussed this in previous streams, but we need to restate this again. That is some really bad cause and effect. Like, that's some really weird cause of effect. Isn't his name cause of effect? It's like, you wear a striped shirt, therefore you're a kid. That's just like saying that, oh, the truck is red, therefore it's a fire truck. Those things are not the same at all. But Flapjack is quite confused about how the world works, but we'll keep going on. What's with Mr. Mayor? This town doesn't have a mayor. Oh. But if there's ever a problem, a skeleton will tell a fish lady about it. So is that why the there was a fishing pole in the lake with a cell phone number on it? I don't know. That's weird. That's politics. That is not politics. That's y'all see this, right? Everyone that I spared is in this room. And this looks like a straight up drunk rabbit. No matter where I go, it's the same menu, the same people. Help, I want new drinks and hot guys. Oh, it's a female rabbit. Or a female rabbit. Not exactly sure. What is this? What is this talking mouth thing? Isn't human food different from monster food? It does things like spoil. Yeah, I agree with that. Yeah, monster food is better than human food. Confirmed. Our food spoils, theirs apparently doesn't. When you eat it, it passes all the way through your whole body. Let me take a drink on that one. Because that poop joke came out of nowhere. Let's continue forward. Disgusting. Yeah, you don't want to make the poop joke. I love to try it sometimes. Which part of that? Like, poo? Or the eating of the human food? Like, which one did he choose? Did you know that cinnamon comes from the inner bark of several tree species from the genus Cinnamon? I did not know that. So, literally, I'm eating tree bark as I'm eating it. So technically, cinnamon is very vegan. Confirmed, cinnamon is vegan. But then again, aren't most spices vegan? Confirmed again. All right, there's a horse. He's got like a sick ass horse mullet going on. The capital's getting pretty crowded, so I've heard they're going to start moving here. Yeah, I bet taxes are terrible there too. But I don't want to see the eraser of our local culture. But I definitely want to see some city slickers slipping. But I definitely want to see some city slickers slip onto their butts. Okay. But this jukebox? Oh, the jukebox is broken. That sucks. Alright, what up? This is Flame Dude, the bartender. Grizzbiz said that he'd offer you a glass of water, but he doesn't touch the stuff. No, duh. He is literally on fire. Those dogs are part of the Royal Guards, the elite military group led by Undyne. Dude, okay, let me get this right. Papyrus, as a skeleton, wants to join the Royal Guards to be part of the elite military group.
but everyone in the Royal Guards apparently is a doll. I think he got the memo really, really wrong, or did not read it correctly. Cause I mean, dogs, bones, I mean, alright, you stay on. I wouldn't do it. I mean, you'd be literally broke in one piece on, God, where is it? Elmzo, when it met the Minx for the first time. Literally, that's how that should be. And that's how it would turn out. Nom, 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 nom. She's rude, loud, and beats up everybody who gets in her way. It's no wonder all the kids want to be like her when they grow up. All the kids want to be hoodlums. Yep, exactly. Brooke on the Minx Island. This dog's bones just nomming away. Brooke was so happy to get off that island. I mean, he lied the attention, but dear God, that would be rough. Okay, so I talked to the bird, I talked to the fire guy, I talked to the fish. I put on a line for some girls today. So he put out the fish line, not Sans and Papayas. Okay, we're connecting these dots slowly. Brooke, son, we love you so much. Please don't leave us. That's exactly what was happening. They literally had bone in mouth holding on to him. Don't leave. And then when he did leave, they were like, no. And Brooke's like, get me the fuck out of here. I don't remember if he asked to see their panties. He might have, because he asks his. Brooke does not discriminate against any of the species. He will ask, if you're a girl, I want to see panties. He even asked Big Mom, can he see her panties? Let that sink in for a moment. Hey, Brooke, carrying just massive bone balls to ask Big Mom to see her panties. God, Brooke be killing it, though. Well, I'm taking that seriously. I'm literally going to make out with a fish. What? Like, just catch the fish? Okay, anyway, I'm not getting into that. It's playing poker against itself. It appears to be losing. What about Dogo? What's he thinking? I'm thinking of getting a spike collar to show off my personality. Alright, that's cool. It makes a statement like, attach the leash to me and take me for a walk, please. Like, that is not what that gives off when you put it on a dog. But, I mean, each day on. Alright. That her gherkin face. That's all I got to say. That her gherkin. Better watch where you sit down in here, kid. Because the big guy will jump onto your lap and give you lots of love and attention. Yeah, how well we know. We're sentries, but we never get any respect. I wish these skeletons would throw us a bone. Literally, just take an arm and throw one. We love bones. I bet you do. I bet you do. This dialogue is insane. What is this dude? This dude looks like a combination of Dumbo the elephant or Dumbo the elephant and the dude from Charlie Brown. Like, they came together and formed this guy. And a mouse. Just for size. Everybody's always laughing and cracking jokes, trying to forget our modern crisis. What is the crisis? Dreariness, crowding, lack of sunlight? Fair enough. I would join them, but I'm not very funny. Got a point there, bro. We all know the underground has problems, but we smell anyway. Why? Can't do anything, so why be morose about it?
say that right? Morose? I think I said that right. Linus and Doma. Linus Tech Tips? Linus, oh, that's the name of him? That was his name? Linus? Because I actually forget most of their names, to be honest. But I do know who the Peanuts are. So, you know, first show the love for them, you know. Showing my age real quick, just showing it off. Okay, continuing forward. Into the library. Okay. We got, like, monster form of Sonic the Hedgehog right here. Welcome to the library. Yes, we know. The sign is misspelled? I didn't even see that! Like, wow, they really butchered that word. Like, they butchered it badly. Like, oh my god. Like, you wouldn't notice that if you didn't talk to him. You just keep walking by, like, oh yeah, it's the library. Yeah, moving on. But they butchered that spelling. So what this dude. The look in your eyes. You're someone that has trouble doing crosswords, aren't you? I think they're projecting how they feel onto us, not the other way around. But, you know, you stand. Got the rhinoceros here. I love working on the newspaper. There's a lot of little to report that we just fill in with comics and games. The local news is literally just comics and games. Cough, cough. I guess she's sick or she's smoking. When I was younger, my teacher gave me word searches when they ran out of assignments. I thought they were a waste of time. Look at me now. I'm the number one word search creator in the entire underground. Either. Oh, so she is smoking too. If you look a little bit closer, you can actually see that she's smoking. Love, hope, and compassion. This is what people say monster souls are made out of. And puppy dog tails and Sailor Moon somehow can be thrown in there. But the absolute nature of soul is unknown. After all, humans have proven their souls don't need these things to exist. Let's reread that. Okay, love, hope, and compassion. That's what they say monster souls are made out of. But the absolute nature of the soul is unknown. After all, humans have proven their souls don't need these to exist. Oh, so what they're saying is that, I guess during the war we proved to the monsters that we don't actually have to show love or anything. So, that's how they view humans. Fearing the humans no longer, we move out of our old city home. We brave harsh cold, damp swamplands, and searing heat until we reach what we know, which we now call our capital. New home. Again, our king is really bad at names. Yeah, he really is. Like, oh my god. Because they are made of magic, monster bodies are attuned to their soul. If a monster doesn't want to fight, its defense will weaken. And the crueler the intentions of our enemies, the more their attacks will hurt us. So, I guess that applies to if you do a genocide run. Like, the fact that you're not really leveling up, you're just... Their souls are becoming more crushed underneath, like, your determination to kill them. I guess that's what it's saying. Therefore, if a being with a powerful soul is struck with desire to kill, let's end the chapter here. No. We need more information on that one, man. Here I am writing this book. A person comes in and picks up the book. They start reading it. Oh, sorry. I'm still writing that one. While monsters are mostly made of magic, human beings are mostly made of water. Touche. I'll give you that one. Humans with their physical form are very stronger than us. Really? Like the fact that they actually consciously know that is interesting. But they would never know the joy of expressing themselves through magic. Yeah, you're right about that. I'd be wishing I was in the magicians. They'll never get a bullet pattern birthday. We can make that work.
It's a school report about a monster funeral. Monster funerals, technically speaking, are cool as heck. When monsters get old and kick the bucket, they turn into ash. At funerals, we take that ash and spread it on that person's favorite thing, and their essence will live on in that thing. Am I at the page minimum yet? I'm kind of sick of writing this. Well, that's interesting that when they die, they become ash and that you're supposed to sprinkle it onto their favorite thing. There's some interesting... Dear God. Like, whose mailbox is this? Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Wait, hold up, hold up, hold up. Are you telling me that Sans' mailbox is the junkiest one, but Papyrus' one is the clean one? There's no way. I mean, it probably is true, but that's almost unbelievable. It's locked from the inside. The key to get in, then. Can we? Oh, that's an ocean back. Well, a lake back there, because look at the iceberg float away. Casually float away. Alright, can we go in here? Okay, their house is locked. Okay. Because I take it that's their house, since it had their name on it. Okay, back to the middle. Got Flapjack's Scraggy right there. Linus, Dumbo right there. We got Satan. Play Monsters and Humans. What exactly am I talking to? Is that a slime? Every tail. You aren't gonna make me be the human again, are you? Oh, they're actually talking to each other. Call me the dad. Ah, be young again. The world sure feels boundless. What a beautiful knock. Maybe if I don't answer, I'll hear it again. Ah, my patience rewards me. Ah. Like, honestly? Like, they're not gonna let me in? That's interesting. Hadouken. Because remember, I just saw ice blocks floating down, so this is where they come from. But why? That isn't... Like, why are they making ice blocks and throwing them into the river? You will learn later. What is happening? I am strong wolf. Yes, he is. He is actually quite strong wolf. You can call him... Beowulf. I'll see myself out now. I will gladly see myself out about that one. Okay, we've read all this stuff, so let's save again and press on forward. Music isn't that bad. What in the world? Did y'all see that? Like, why is it getting misty? Can't see anything. It's Papyrus. Human! Allow me to tell you about some complex feelings. Feelings like the joy of finding another pasta lover. Hey, most people love pasta. Then the admiration for another puzzle-solving skills. The desire to have a cool, smart person think you are cool. These feelings,
It must be what you are feeling right now. I'm not exactly sure what I should be feeling right now, to be honest. I can hardly imagine what it must be like to feel that way. After all, I am very great. That ego is huge. I don't ever wonder what having lots of friends is like. Yes, he does. He said it like an hour ago that he was actually curious about friends. I pity you, lonely human. Worry not. You shall be lonely no longer. I, the Great Papyrus, will be your... friend? No. No, this is all wrong. I can't be your friend. You're human. Well, we can all be humans. I must capture you. Then I can fulfill my lifelong dream. Powerful, popular, prestigious. He is very confused about what he wants in life. That's Papyrus, the newest member of the Royal Guard. Dun dun dun. Well, this is happening. He likes to say, yeah, he does like to say that. As he says it. He's preparing a bone attack. Flirty? Feel your ultimate feelings. Well, I'm a skeleton with very high standards. I have zero redeeming qualities. Don't think that's the right option. Let's go with the spaghetti guys. Oh no, you're meeting all my standards. I guess that means I have to go on a date with you. Dun dun dun. Let's date later after I capture you. Wait, dude, what? No, that's not how that works. That's not how that works. You don't bone on the first date, okay? Papyrus is thinking about what to wear for his date. Okay. Papyrus is thinking about what to cook for his date. We can't spare him yet. Alright, let's flirt. You flirt, but to no avail. Seems acting will escalate this battle. This date later comes to capture you. He dabs some bone cologne behind his ears. Dude, he about to start flexing on us right quick. Straight up, he's about to just start flexing. Like, yeah, you know, girl, yeah, I've been hitting up the gym trying to make some gains in my bones. I've been drinking my milk, trying to make them as hard as possible. just like weird, dude. Flex like ooh, basically. Flex like ooh, flex like ooh. Move them bricks. But, dude, if he flexed like ooh right now and drunk some milk, I'll probably blow my mind. But he's actually not trying to really attack me, to be honest. Wait. He dabs some marinara sauce behind his ears? You've got to be kidding me. Wait, hold up. How does he even have ears? Like, he's bone. I mean... never mind, moving on. Let's just keep flirting. Let's see where this goes, guys. Because this marinara sauce is, he's really trying. They have some MTT brand... Ishii cream behind his ears?
What is that? Like, is that like something you put on to make bones better? I've thought about doing that with vanilla. Putting some vanilla behind your ears. You might as well just put cinnamon behind your ears. It'll work faster. Just dab some cinnamon back there. Just dab it back there. I don't know, like, for some odd reason, I feel like flirting is, like, the weirdest thing in this battle. Because he keeps just dabbing this stuff. He dabs some anime powder behind his ear. What is anime powder? Let's check on him. Let's actually see what he's like to say. Like, I mean, the only thing I can do next is actually just insult him. Some cute juice behind his ear. Can't spare him yet. Let's check him again. Attraction slime behind his ear. Okay, dude. I guess, like, I'm gonna have to insult him at this point. Beauty yogurt? What? Like, okay, we have to call this one out. You just don't be dabbing beauty yogurt behind your ears, man. How selfish. You want me to feel better about fighting you? I don't deserve such hospitality from you. That's not what we were saying, but... Okay, that's how you take it. Papyrus realized he doesn't have ears. Yeah, we've been saying that. There's no need to lie to yourself. Your barbs hide a hidden affection, your emotional cactus. I am so confused. Papyrus is rattling his bones. What is he like, about to like two-step on? He's about to be like... About to like walk up on us and be like, yeah, girl, yeah, yeah. Like, is that what he's about to do? I am very confused about this character. He's crackling. Don't waste your words on me. Dude, I am lost just as you are. Price is preparing a bone attack. Okay. So, no, because acting won't escalate this battle. Okay. Price is trying real hard to break. Like, I get, like, what's next? So you don't want to fight again. Let's see if you can handle my fable blue attack. Yeah, we just don't move. What? You're blue now. That's my attack. What just happened? Wait, I'm still... Like, I almost made it! Bry is trying to be cool, like, oh. Oh. hold up longer to jump higher. Okay. Thank you for giving us that tip now. How did I still miss? Oh my god. It smells like bone. Don't make me use my special attack. Please don't. Oh my god. I can almost taste my future popularity. What the fuck is that? Oh, with 5 HP, I'm not sure how I can die. Can I get this? Enterprise unparalleled spaghetti tour. You're too weak. I was easy able to capture. I will now send you to the capture zone. Or, as Sans calls it, our garage. You're in the doghouse now. Yeah. But okay. Is a squeaky chew toy. Some kibble and bits. Fortunately, it's just dry food. Like, I really wonder if you're supposed to get captured there. It's too small to sleep on. Aw, it's for smaller dogs. It's a note from Papayas. Sorry, I have to lock you in the guest room until Undyne arrives. Feel free to make yourself at home. Refreshments and accommodations have been provided. Nearly yours, Papayas. Okay, bro. Dude. How can I just walk out? And why is there another mouse hole there? I literally just walked out. Yeah, I just walked out. What was the point of even being captured? What was the point of that? I am very confused about what he was trying to prove. That character there. Oh my god. I don't know why I didn't just take the shuttle all the way there. It would have been a lot quicker than what I'm doing. Anyway, let's see if we can continue forward. Where could that human have gone? Really? Wait, it's right in front of me. Hello, I was worried that you had gotten lost. Dude, you just put me in jail and I broke free. Why are you worrying if I got lost? It's sure relief to know that you're all right here. Wait a second. You're not supposed to have skated. Dude, he's so slow at picking up on this stuff. Get back there. Okay, so we're not supposed to lose this character. I'm not thinking about that date thing. Don't make me use my special attack. What is the special attack? Crap, I did not. That's some bone cologne. That bone cologne. It helps you. I guess I can almost taste my future popularity. Ah, oh, man, I forgot that it did that. I tried. I really did try that one. Much. Please ask before you escape. Why would I ask when you want, when you missing? I got worried sick. Slightly bone trottle papyrus. Oh, there's a hot dub cut up. Oh, a hot dog cut up into kibbles. That's nice of him. Is the blanket bigger? It's still too small to sleep in. So, moving on. Like, why? Like, I don't understand. Like, why? Why does he not understand that, that is not how you capture somebody. As I go the wrong way. Again. Okay, so we have lost papyrus twice now. So, the goal is not going too well. We need to not lose. That is the thing. And we're probably getting closer to actually winning. Back again, eh? I suppose it's my fault. I told you before that I would make you spaghetti. That's only natural that you would want to see me, in the dire hope that I would make you some. Well, I understand. Papyrus is hungry too. Hungry for justice! What is like, I knew that it was coming, but I still got that messed up. Man, God. If I die again, I mean, I kinda know what's happening. Oh, Calm down, bro. Calm down. Yeah, that is very grammatically wrong. Like, I don't want to read that out loud. Because crit form would be not as persistent as papyrus. I'm not even going to try it. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. We're still in the dog pound. Still. Damn kibbles. Damn kibbles. Okay. What is this? The third attempt? Going on the fourth? We are really doing bad at this, guys. Are you just missing my face so much? I'm not sure I can fight someone who feels this way. Mostly, I'm getting really tired of capturing you. Nah, I'm good. Okay. I guess I'll accept my failure. Wait, what? Guys, literally, lose too much? Eventually, he'll just let you win. Okay. I was actually going to try it again, but I guess not. I can't even stop someone as weak as you. Well, you know, at least you try. That is going to be disappointed in me. I'll never join the Royal Guards, and... Oh. And my friend quantity will remain stagnant. What should I say? Let's be friends. You want to be friends with me? Well then, I guess I can make an allowance for you. Humans. Wow, we have even had our first date. And I've already managed to hit the friend zone. That's what you don't want to do. I'm pretty sure he's going very regressive on what he's trying to do here. Like, you want to date, not to be friend zone. I don't know what to tell you, man. Easter young. Who knew that all I needed to make pals was to give people awful puzzles and then fight them? You taught me a lot, human. I hereby grant you permission to pass through. I'll give you directions to the surface. Continue forward until you reach the end of the cavern. Then when you reach the capital, cross the barrier. That's the magical seal trapping us all underground. Anything can enter through it, but nothing can exit except someone with a powerful soul. Okay. Like you. Wait, hold up. I thought you called me weak, though. That's why the king wants to acquire a human. He wants to open the barrier with the soul power. Then us monsters can return to the surface. Oh, I almost forgot to tell you. To reach the exit, you have to pass through the king's castle. Well, that escalated too quickly. King of all monsters, Asgore. He is, well, big fuzzy. The king is a big fuzzy pushover. Everybody loves the guy. I am certain if you just say, excuse me, Mr. Dreamer? Can I please go? Dreamer. Man, I am so bad at these names. Moving on. He'll guide you right to the barrier himself. Anyway, that's enough talking. Have you at home being a cool friend? Feel free to come by and have a... Guys, how does he walk? Like, what was that? That actually looked quite scary. Alright, let's save up. Let's go on that date. this random date. Okay. Two positive foods out of 15 so far tonight. Dude, that's real bad. That's real bad, man. Like, there should not be that many people coming in saying that they think they have the flu, but they really don't. And then be going to the ER to do it. Like, just stop. Just wait for the morning. And then do it. Hey, there's a provider. Tell each other. So you came back to have a date with me. You must be really serious about dates. I have to take you someplace really special. A place I like to spend a lot of time. He is power walking. Where's he taking us? My house.
Oh my god. This dude literally just walked away from his house, bring me back to his house to tell me the place he likes to spend the most time to. Seriously.
They just try not to have to go to work. Yeah. I mean, most people are trying not to go to work. I mean, but flu season's gonna last all the way until May, I've heard. That's what, like, my coworker told me. I mean, we're like, barely into February. So, I mean, I don't know. I honestly don't know. Like, what are they gonna do? Just be sick until February or something like that? Okay. But anyway, my house. Let's check out this. Is that fire coming underneath that door? Yeah, it might as well be year long. I mean, is it flu season? I mean, I don't know. Hey, because I know during the summer, there's less likely to get flu because of, especially in the south, because of how hot and humid it is. But now it's all dry and stuff. Like, whose room do you think is whose? Like, do you think San's room is the one on fire? Or is San's room the one that says, do not enter? Like, which one would actually be... Y'all see that, right? He literally watched me walk into the kitchen. He was like, what are you doing? Press. I increased the height of my sink. Dude, why? Now I can fit more bones under it. Take a look-see. That escalated a lot quicker than we needed it to. Why is there a dog in his cabinet? Why do they have a dog? Like, really, why would they have a dog? They're bone. I just catch that meta in K-line. Curses! So Sans is the one that's room is on fire. What? Stop plaguing my life with incidental music. Sans killing it though. Ha, interested in my food museum? Please. Use my clarinet art show. Half of the fridge is filled with containers of all labeled spaghetti. The other half contains nothing but an empty bag of chips. What? Why does he have an empty bag of chips? My brother always goes out to eat, but recently he tried baking something. It was like a quiche. But filled with a sugar non-egg substance. Isn't that just a pie? Then, like, aren't quiches technically pie-like? How absurd. I'm absurd with that, dude. I don't even know what you're referring to. It's a dirty sock with a series of notes on it. Sans, please pick up your sock. Okay. Don't put it back down. Move it. Okay. You moved it 2 inches. Move it to your room. Okay. And don't bring it back. Okay. It's still here. Didn't you just say not to bring it back to my room? Forget it. What is wrong with this family? Why do they have a TV? Like, how do they have a TV is another question.
Oh, it's my favorite game show. It says stay tuned for a new program on TV.
What? It's usually better than this. This is just a bad episode. Don't judge me. Yeah.
You touch the couch, it makes a jangling sound. You find a bunch of loose coins inside the couch. You got 20. Oh my god. Just like a couch, finding random money in it. Alright, what's this diary for? It's a joke book. Oh shit. This should be interesting. Yes. The joke book was. Oh my god. The joke book was a quantum physics book? That's not a joke, dude. It's something that most people will never understand. You look inside. Inside the quantum physics books was another joke book. Wait, there. Oh my god. You look inside. There's another quantum physics. Oh my. Really? You decide. Yeah, that can get interesting. Let's think of a quantum physics joke. Okay, I don't really have one. So, you know, in the parallel universe. That's all I got. I'm gonna see myself out with that one, guys. That's my room. If you finish looking around, we could go in and do whatever people do when they date. Not right now, bro. A classic image. Always reminds me of what's important in life. Bones? Strong bones? Let's see if we can understand. Oh, that door is locked. Oh, snuck, guys. Looks like we might be going through some stuff tomorrow. Let's go see if we can find that dog. We're just gonna do a quick search around, see if we see the dog anywhere. And we're gonna leave the surprise of what happens in Paris's bedroom for tomorrow's episode. Let's save again. Oh my god, this game, man. Like, the fact that that bunny does not like that bunny for some abnormal reason is weird in itself. Okay. No, you're saying no because I'm leaving you in suspense? Dude, you gotta hype it up, man. You gotta hype it up. Suspense is real. Alright, so where does this even lead to? Yeah, we are not going that deep. That is way further deep than I want to go right now. It's too funny. Dude, I know this game and this writing is just, it's off the wall, man. But I'm actually really curious, like, now that I can stand here. Like, Sans has a whole bunch of junk mail. Papyrus is like the one that's like super serious. Like, their personalities are literally the opposite of the way that they're written. But, I mean, they are brothers, so I don't know. About it. But, yeah, on that note, we'll be signing off for right now so that we can come back tomorrow and see what happens in the, How did he put it? Let's go see it one more time before we log out. That's my room. If you finish looking around, we could go in and do whatever people do when they date. Not tonight, man. Not tonight. Papyrus, I'm a little tired. Got a little kink in my shoulder. You know, we'll have to come back for some hot human on bone action. Oh my god, dude, this game. I see why people actually thoroughly enjoy this game now. Because this dialogue's insane. Like, it's actually something that
Like, when you're interacting with real life, this is the stuff you would think about and how you would react. And just to feel, like, just the way it looks, dude. It looks kind of cool. It looks, it actually has, like, it has a unique charm. Snowden. Welcome to Snowden. But yeah, on that note, we'll be leaving it for now so we can, hype up the, So we can hype up the pious bedroom activities. Because, you know, we've already friend-zoned them. So, it's never going to get past, what, zero base for him? He's never going to hit a home run, never get the third, or second, or first. I mean, he's just been friend-zoned. And the fact that we died, like, three times trying to fight this dude. Maybe even four. It might have been four. I have to recheck the replay for that one. But yeah. Anyway. Let's sign out for tonight. So we can come back to, you know, how epic this game is going to be.